Hi everyone, welcome to Powershell for Penetration Testers at Pentester Academy. In this video, let's discuss WebShells. WebShells are very useful when we have the ability to upload a file on a web server which serves active pages. This could be done with the help of any misconfiguration or poor filtering. For example, any website or web server which allows image uploads, and if it is poorly filtered or poorly coded, we can upload our ASPX or any other shell depending on the web server. It could also be exploited with SQL injection, or if we get access to the OS of a web server, we can put it there as a sort of a backdoor. So we will discuss in detail Antak from Nishank, which is a web shell written in ASP.NET, that is ASPX. We will see this one in detail. We will not discuss this. This is just an honorary mention. It is this backdoor or this web shell is PowerShell Web Access from Microsoft. To Microsoft's credit, it needs administrative username and password. That is, you can always access that machine from some other way. And it also allows for authorization. That is, it not only you must have administrative user and username and password, you must also be explicitly authorized to use PowerShell Web Access. It is a PowerShell console in web browser. If you browse to it, you enter your username and password, and you will get a full-featured PowerShell console. In fact, it was from PowerShell Web Access that I got the idea of Antak. So you may read my blog post, which is listed in the next slide, for PowerShell Web Access. For Antak, let's see it in action. We can run PowerShell commands or native commands and PowerShell scripts from it. We could also upload and download files from it. So this is Antak on a test machine in my lab. You can use clear to clear its console and help to list the help about each functionality. Each command in PowerShell in Antak is executed in a separate PowerShell process. So for stateful commands or scripts, you must take care. So let's just run get host on this target. So this is actually some old machine in my lab. So it is running PowerShell version 2. And let's see our privileges. So we are running with a really low user privilege. We can also list processes, etc. So this is a simple way we can execute commands on the remote machine. This all is listed in the help, so even if it is not visible right now, you can have a look at it later on. Now, to execute script, there are three ways of doing it. The first one is to paste the script here and press encode and execute button. The second one is to use our so frequently used PowerShell one-liner. And the third one is to upload a script to the target and executing it. In fact, as the help suggests, you can, if your script is really small, we can use it in a semicolon separated one liner as well. So these are the ways you can execute a script on the target server. So let's try to execute a script there, because we are running with low privileges. Let's run get information and let's make the function call here. Let's see, because this is a big script, let's see if we are able to execute it. Otherwise, we would remove the help from there. Okay, so lot of errors because it is unable to read some registry keys, but we at least have few commands. Shares, environment variables, etc. So we were at least able to execute a script on the target machine. Okay, looks like we crashed it. Okay, anyways, so we can also use our one-liner download and execute. In fact, let's try to move to another shell. Let's once again run. Reverse PowerShell shellcode from Metasploit. So let's paste it here and run encode and execute. Because we are running with the low privilege user, we may or may not get, okay, we got a shell with low privileges. So this way we can also escalate this or change this to a metaprinter session or try privilege escalation, etc. So that is up to us. Now let me just reload this. So these are just two ways to execute scripts. Let's try uploading something to the target machine. For that, so uploading and downloading file is a bit tricky. We must provide the path to where we have write access. For example, C Windows stamp, and let's upload some huge script there. Let's load the PowerPrinter module. And then so we provided the complete path on the server, browsed the file on our local machine, and let's press this. So it says that the file has been uploaded to this place, but with double slash. So this slash was actually not required. Let's see. So good, the file has been uploaded. So now we can execute it with simple PowerShell command. And because it is a module, we can import it, and in the same command, we can execute functions from it. So for example, let's try this. Let's say import module. This and check VM. So let's try this. So as you can see that, so ignore this warning. As you can see that PowerPrinter detected that this is a VMware machine. We call the check VM function of PowerPrinter. So this way we can upload files as well. Note that we could also use PowerPrinter with previous one-liner etc. as well. Now let's try to download a file. In fact, let's try to download our PowerPrinter back. So to download a file, we must provide the complete path to it and then press download. So it takes some time, but it gets downloaded. And if you open it, you can see that we were able to download it. So that is all about Antak. Hope it comes handy in some of your penetration tests or red teaming activity. You can read my blog posts about both of these things here. And that is all for this video. If you are enjoying your time at Pentester Academy, please recommend us to your friends and colleagues in the information security community.